Race fans, 2 weeks ago at the Ironman 55 at the Federated Auto Parts I-55 Raceway, Jerry Coons Jr. showed up, drove one of the Scott Petrie racing cars, and what a show he put on. Got his 11th career victory. Jerry, congratulations, bud.
Thanks. It was a fun night. Had some plans changed kind of that week, so we ended up going to Peavey, and it turned out to be a good choice.
Now, Friday night, you won the preliminary night of the two-day event. Now, you told me in Victory Lane that the Silver Crown driving technique come to play.
Well, a little bit. That place was pretty dry slick, and it was right around the bottom. So, you know, that place with that concrete wall around the bottom like that, it's kind of like running the guardrail on a mile. So, like I said, I started fourth in the feature there and got into third pretty quick, and the first two cars were kind of up off the wall. They weren't really where I thought they needed to be, and I just dove down there and took the lead coming off turn four. So it worked just getting down there right on the wall, and that's where the groove was all night.
Jerry, last night we were at the Mighty Macon Speedway in Macon, Illinois. I've talked to a lot of drivers. They said the track was very tricky, but you came through, had a solid third place finish.
Yeah, I had a good starting spot, you know, starting fourth, and we were up in the top, I don't know, third or fourth there, and then I had a moment where I screwed up and tried to crash half the field there coming off of four, got sideways, and went back to eighth. So just, you know, it was just a mistake on my part, and like I said, had a great race car, was able to drive back up to third, and you know, who knows what would happen if I hadn't screwed up there, we might have had a shot at the win. But yeah, I mean, the track I thought was good. You know, it was on the bottom for a while, that the top came in, and really probably halfway through, it had kind of two grooves depending on what your car was working best. I passed cars on the bottom, then got to the top and passed some cars, and I know for the battle for the lead was pretty good there in lap traffic. So you know, it was kind of rough early. They did a good job trying to widen the track out with all, you know, we've had a lot of rain in this area, so they got it widened up there and for the feature, and it was a heck of a race.
Now, you're a regular with the USAC Silver Crown, you're a regular with the sprint cars and the midget cars. You're one of six drivers to win the Triple Crown all in the same year. What's more fun, the midgets, the sprints, or the crown cars?
I think my heart's still in the midgets. Yeah, definitely like the midgets. I haven't really run the sprint car deal. I've definitely cut back a little bit. Haven't been running nearly as much of that, doing all the Silver Crown races. And just have always enjoyed the midgets. And I think that's what I always love.
Now, you've made several laps around Angel Park Speedway in your career.
I got a couple around here. So I don't know if that really matters or not. But, you know, a lot of great race cars. A lot of people have been here. It's been quite a few years since I've been here now. So a little bit different. I've run here a few times that they took the guardrail out around the bottom, put the tires down, and so you know, the level of competition and the talents that here, I don't know that it matters how many laps you got around here. It's getting the track figured out, car figured out, and putting all the laps together.
Good luck tonight.
All right, thank you.